What is up, gamers? Welcome back to another, what will be another very chaotic vlog from yours truly, Morticia Adams. Okay, wait, before we begin, everyone needs to take a moment to admire how ugly this pullover sweatshirt I got is. It's ugly and wonderful, just like myself. Hi, and real quick, before I start going off on some like random existential tangent, two things. I'm really sorry I haven't posted in a hot minute. The holiday time is a chaotic time, and I didn't mean to not post a video last week, but I decided to do nothing instead of attempting to create anything at all because I was tired. That's my only excuse. I didn't post anything last week because I was exhausted. But hopefully this dumb little vlog will make up for it anyways. Second, I have to burp. Okay, third, actually. We're officially at like a little bit over 300 subscribers. Thank you everyone who has subscribed, who has liked, who has commented, who has done anything at all, disliked, I don't care, it doesn't really matter. Engagement is engagement at the end of the day, so. But no, seriously, thank you guys so much because I was thinking about it this time last year. I was under 100. I think honestly I was probably at like 50, 60, maybe 70 subscribers this time last year. And now I'm at 300 and that's fucking nutty to me. That's 300 people just saying hello to my dumb ugly little ass and I'll appreciate it because attention is attention and that's what I live for. So what do I want to talk about today? Like actually, like for real, should we do some New Year's resolutions? I don't know. Cause last year, I even made a video about it. I did some like New Year's resolutions and none of them happened. And we can tell that none of them did actually happen because I'm still filming in the same pink bedroom in my parents' house that I was last year. New at fuck resolutions.
We'll have burlesque performances, we will have mini, we will have NC-17 rated. You guys are allowed to photograph and video.
It's art. I don't want to say New Year's resolutions. What are we doing? We're going to be doing New Year's... So, you know, I don't know. Fuck New Year's resolutions. We're not doing New Year's resolutions. Those are last decade. We're doing New Year's... I don't know. What's a word that white people use in... Manifestations. We're going to be doing some New Year's manifestations in this video.
Wait. Okay.
Is that Miss Ariana Grande? Yeah. Wow. My fans. What is up, gamers? Should we say the classic? Should we love ourselves more? Should we love each other more? Should we just love more? Because I think that'd be a good start. Because personally, I'm tired of hating myself constantly. I mean, having a self-deprecating sense of humor is always who I'm gonna be. That's never gonna change anytime soon. That's just who I'm gonna be always and forever. But at the same time, if I'm gonna clown on myself as much as I do, I also need to love myself, like, at the same amount. You need to do a little bit of math. I was never very good at math, but the levels are like this, and the levels need to be like this. So I need to even this out. So, I don't know, maybe I'm gonna step in front of the mirror every day, look at myself and say, hey, you're funny. You have curly hair, and that's pretty neat. Your skin might be ugly, but you do a pretty good job at taking care of it and covering it up with makeup and tricking other people into thinking that you have a good complexion. That's awesome.
You refuse me, honey, you'll lose me, then you'll be left alone. Oh, baby, tell us all. Tell me I'm your own.
Your hood, Hollywood couldn't change me. Shout out to my haters, sorry that you couldn't face me. Ain't being cocky, we just vindicated. Let's believe that what we done is home, it will be syndicated. I don't know. This night just remind me of everything they deprived me of.
And maybe, I don't know, you will take a notebook and write down some positive shit that happened to you that day. So, like, I don't know, maybe, you know, your car broke down on the side of the road, and while you were waiting for, who are the car people? Triple A. Maybe while you're waiting for Triple A to come fix your shit, the sun is setting over the mountains, and you just take a moment to realize how beautiful the sun is, and you go, hey man, I haven't looked at the sunset in a while, and who knew the sky could get so orange or so pink or so cotton candy purple. I don't know. And instead of focusing on the fact that your car is fucking broken because it's about 20 years old, you write down in your little positive notebook of positive moments and thoughts and kinds and fucking whatever, imagine if I knew any words in the English language other than fuck. You write down how pretty nifty that sunset was. I don't know, maybe you do that while I say nice things to myself in the mirror. So I guess that would be a pretty good New Year's manifestation. Can you do in the new year, in the new decade, what else can we do? Oh, let's create more. Let's just create, and not create more, like, let's just create some shit. Let's just make shitty stuff, right? Because fuck this, like, fuck, just try, fuck, like.
Into the darkness, we'll go, you'll never make it through the night.
Fuck just trying to be perfect all the time. If you focus too hard on always trying to pick the right word or editing every little sentence you just type out, you're never gonna complete an entire page, and you're just gonna dog yourself down because you're not writing enough, you're not drawing enough, you're not singing enough, you're not filming enough, you're not doing enough, but you stop yourself because you want it to be as perfect as possible. But the thing is, you can't be as perfect as possible unless you know how to suck complete ass first. So that's what I mean. Create more. Just create as much as possible. Because, like, I have written a dozen shitty poems, right? And as a whole of each of those poems, I really don't think they're all that great. But
Always. So,
Once upon a time, at the foot of a great mountain, there was a town where the people known as Happy Folk lived. Their very existence was a mystery to the rest of the world.
Back to another segment of Venus Reads, or Reads by Venus. I haven't decided on the title yet. And today we will be reading from Craigslist Bets. Titled, Your Dick Pic Cured My Breast Cancer, W for M, or Woman for Man, for those not familiar with the Craigslist lingo.
But when I look back at each of those poems and I read through them again, I find one little line. And I think, hey, you know what? All this might be shit, but that one line, that ain't bad. That line ain't bad. So I'll remember that line, and I'll tuck it away, and then next time I write something else, and I'm trying to think of what more words I can say, I can go back to my little pocket where I remember I put that little line, and I go, hey, I think this little line would be pretty neat in the next thing that I'm working on. And then, you know, that thing that I'm working on, what if that little line from that one shitty little poem that I made many, 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 many moons ago actually finishes and perfectly completes the thing that I'm working on right now? Did that make sense? Probably not, and that's why I never became a teacher. That's why I could never be an English teacher. Because I think I lost myself there for a second. But do you see what I mean? Do you understand the thought process, maybe, potentially, behind everything I just said?
Now make some motherfucking noise! And she made her own motherfucking costume.
Like, just create and create and create and just create and never stop creating. If you have the idea, just fucking do it, because I don't know, the world's on fire right now, and World War III could happen now also. So, fuck it. Just fuck it. Write a poem. Get inebriated. Do it in front of your friends. Cry a little bit, you know, or write some fan fiction. Post it on archives of our own. Get a couple hits. Maybe get one or two comments. Fuel off of those two comments, because for whatever reason, at least two people took time to read your stupid Spider-Woman fan fiction for whatever fucking reason. But you know, that made you feel good, and you never would have gotten those comments, or you never would have gotten those tears if you just didn't make the thing, if you just didn't create the thing. And like, those feelings, those comments, those whatever, that's what fuels you, that's what fuels me, that's what makes me feel good. So in the end, even if you think something's super shitty, just do it anyways, put it out there anyways, because like I said, either you can reuse it later on, or someone, some no-name stranger on the internet is gonna be like, hey, that was decent, and I'll be like, fuck, dude, thanks. Another thing that we're gonna do is we are not going to accept the fact, whether we think it or whether someone else tells us this, but me and you, we're not hard to love. We are not hard to love in the slightest. Can we be stubborn? Yes. Can we be absolutely annoying? Yes. Can we not deal with certain things correctly and act like jackasses and maybe say things that don't come out the way that you had intended. Yes. But guess what? To find people and be with people, whether it be friends, family, whomsoever, we are only going to surround ourselves with people who just love us at our current state. And will obviously encourage us to grow and be better, of course, but the people we find in this upcoming new year, new decade, we'll find it easy to love us as who we are now. And not want us to, not want us to change ourselves and mold ourselves into something that we are not. Be with people in this new year that love me for me and love you for you and encourage us to grow, but also accept that we are on our own little path into achieving the great something or other. Truly profound. Profound.
That's no problem. You guys have got some good intentions for the new year. Get those out there, man. Hell yeah!
Hell yeah!
Some bad shit coming. Hell yeah!
Hell yeah!
If you're ready to love yourself in 2020, say fuck yeah!
Fuck yeah!
If you do everything that makes you happy in 2020, say hell yeah!
Hell yeah!
Say hell yeah!
Hell yeah!
That's what I'm talking about. Come on, y'all, make some noise until we count down.
Another new thing that me and you are going to start doing, we are going to no longer equate being tough and being hard and being hollow with being strong. That ain't it. No. Donezo. In the trash can. Over it. We hate it. Out. That is out. That is so last decade. We are crying more, boys. We are crying way more in this coming decade because crying, as it turns out, feels really fucking good. You know what? Me and you, we aren't hollow. We aren't hard. We are fleshy, squishy little creatures who feel things literally all the time. So guess what? If you're upset, then let everyone know that you're fucking upset. If something hurt you, then let them know that it hurt you. Being silent isn't strong. Being expressive, being this motion, just being all of this is way stronger than just sitting in the dark. Okay? Because it's what, if you're sitting in the dark, you don't really know what the fuck's going on, and no one else around you, the people right outside your bedroom who are knocking on your door, do not know what the fuck is going on either. So stop. Just let them know how you feel. The worst that can happen is that they get upset. And guess what? People get fucking upset all the time. You're upset right now, okay?
Let's give it up for Andromeda. Get your dollies out.
Saying you need to, for every emotion that you feel, you need to express it immediately. Trust me, because as much as I wish I could be like that, I'm not entirely. I still need a 3-day processing time for any and all emotions that I have. But I rather take 3 days than, you know, 3 weeks, 3 months, 3 years of saying nothing at all. I just. It's okay to cry. You feel so much better when you do, and it doesn't sit inside of you just rotting away. Because that's how you end up hollow in the first place, right? It's when you take all these bad things and you just let them eat away at all your guts till you're nothing. So you're just some weird little flesh suit with nothing inside. Can you see that a fire in the just fuck. If you feel it, fucking feel it and let other people know, and let other people know what's going on with you, okay? Being soft is rad, and that is the campaign slogan I will be running on in 2020. Thank you. The thing that we're gonna start doing, or more so doing more of, is we are going to document everything as much as possible. We are going to take as many pictures as we can. We are going to film everything. We are going to fill up notebooks on top of notebooks on top of notebooks. Because one of your biggest fears is one day you're going to just wake up and not remember anything at all. And it's a pretty valid anxiety that we have, is because our grandmother, God rest her soul, had dementia and spent the later half of her life not knowing who anyone or anything was at all. And that's fucking terrifying.
That's the art I was looking
at. My last two brain cells.
Make me go to rehab, I said
no, no, no.
Yes, I've been
like, when I come back, you'll know, no, no, no.
No swinging, just pushing.
No swinging, just pushing.
You're swinging, Colin.
Is this art?
Oh, yeah.
Your mouth was hurt.
Also, I'm sorry that I'm full vagina out right now, everyone. I don't think anyone does, but it just occurred to me.
Please include that audio of you going. Sorry.
My poor dad's gonna be like, what happened?
What's your dad calling you?
Pumpkin.
So you know what? As embarrassing as it might be sometimes to constantly be filming stuff or always taking pictures of yourself or buying new notebooks and filling them up with half pages of dumb little thoughts that you had during that dumb little day. It doesn't matter, because fuck, what if you just don't remember any of it at all? What if you don't remember what you look like? What if you don't remember that dumb little thought you had on that dumb little day? What if you don't, I don't know. It's fucking scary. So you know what? Get over. You're like, I feel, get over it. It doesn't matter, because one day you might not know anything at all. Okay, just fucking get over it. If you want to write it, write it. If you want to film it, film it. If you want to take a million fucking pictures of yourself, then take a million fucking pictures of yourself. Okay, do it while you can. Do it while you remember.
I like the effect to put on your voice for this.
Take your protein pills and put your helmet on. Ground control to Major Tom. 7, 6, commencing count.
And one last thing to close everything out in the new year, new decade, next 10 fucking chaotic years of stupid bullshit nonsense that you're probably gonna go through. Just remember, no matter how bad it might get again and 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 again, no matter how bad it could get, just remember, for the love of God, remember that you will always gain more than you lose. And that is the only profound thought you have ever come up with in your entire 23 years of existence on this hellish nightmare planet. You will always, always gain more than you lose.
I love the vlog.
Okay, I think that's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, have a good rest of your day or night or decade, wherever this video finds you. And I'll catch you next time, okay? Okay, bye.